is joining us this morning from Deepverge, because it's been a busy week for you. On Monday, you announced that you've teamed up with Microsaic to combine their contamination, it's a big word, Jerry, for this time of the morning, detection equipment with your modern water laboratory equipment and also your commercial network. So we're going to go into the details of that a little bit later on. But the news of the day is this $5 million dollar worth of orders just for modern water equipment alone in the first quarter, or £3.6 million even. So plenty to discuss. A warm welcome to Proactive. Always great to have you with us, Jerry. So are you overstretched?
Absolutely not, no. You know, this is definitely the largest order book that Modern Water has ever had in its 30-year history in Q1. For the full year. So we've actually hit that in Q1. And because we've actually had increased capacity in our York laboratories, which was actually originally the production that was actually carried out in the US, and now with the opening of our extended production capacity in China in quarter two, we not only can actually meet these orders, but we have the capacity to actually to double that before the end of this year. So we're certainly ready to push off into that. I mean, the company itself is actually divided in three. And, you know, those three are lab skin, modern water, the environmental science, and our new skin trust club. And each of those towers have their own teams, and they're working to the maximum, stretched, but they're very happy. So all good.
Keeping everyone busy. So what is driving this huge increase in China orders?
Well, obviously being the first out of the starting post with COVID-19 over a year ago, back as far as February of last year in 2020, the Chinese authorities issued a directive relating very specifically to the hygiene of water. And while, you know, tenders are processed all the way through the year, it takes that length of time. Like, we're already there since 2013, a wholly owned subsidiary. So we were in the midst of all of this. And it took this length of time to actually process that. So while the orders are actually very large, the lead time to get those have probably been about 6 or 7 months to actually get us to this point in time.
And are they looking for something in particular, or is it across your modern water range?
Well, you know, we announced back last year that the Microtox laboratory equipment was the innovation product of the year in laboratories in China. So that itself actually led to quite a lot of interest. We already have products installed in five of the 23 provinces in China. So again, good reference points on that. So the demand was already there, the knowledge, the Microtox brand was already recognized, and, you know, China pouring money into actually keeping the water clean to try and stem further pandemics and epidemics. I suppose, you know, we're in the right place at the right time.
And where else are you seeing traction?
Well, actually, certainly we're seeing traction in Ireland. Mm-hmm. We're seeing traction with an accent like this and half the team Irish. Well, obviously, you'd expect that. Obviously, the US, a substantial amount of interest there. Mm-hmm. And that's private. So it's not necessarily government led. And certainly, you know, the cruise industry, we're still in deep discussions in that area. Cruise industry is fine and are in need of it. The issues relate to the authorities at the points of where they actually stop off, and getting all of those to sign up just takes time.
Okay. Let's talk revenues now. Maybe give us a bit more of a guide as to what we can expect for this year. And also, does this include what you've announced today?
Well, you know, one of the reasons why we were able to actually give a guidance of 10 million in January, as early as January, is because we can see so far ahead. As you can see from these orders, a lot of these were actually in or actually coming in, and we could actually see them. And while we're happy to say that our guidance remains at 10 million, mm-hmm. on the pace of the growth in the last, you know, H1, H2 of 2020, we grew at 300%. in the last quarter on quarter, we grew at 250%. So quarter on quarter going forward, 10 million, you know, I'm not saying we'll do it in our sleep, but we'll certainly do it with comfort.
So you're expecting this to increase then?
No comment. My nomad is listening.
Okay. Let's talk about what I mentioned at the very beginning, Microsaic. How does this fit into the picture, the one that you announced on Monday?
Well, you know, one of the great parts of actually having modern water, the existing distribution, and they're already in 60 countries, the installations, and distributors that actually relate and supply the consumables and renewable consumables into that these sectors, they hadn't fully been, I won't say the word exploited, but they certainly hadn't been expanded to the point of where their capacity of actually increasing revenue could be to existing clients. So when we brought in our Deepverge sales organization and expertise, we began to accelerate that quite substantially. And the laboratory equipment that Microsaic have miniaturized a lot of what we've got, and also their own equipment. So we've got an existing distribution channel for the Microsaic kits that they actually have. So, and that was why I was perfectly interested in getting involved with Microsaic back, you know, a couple of months ago when we actually seriously had a look at this. So their equipment also is automating some of our downstream production in York. So that means it's fully automated. It will be without manual intervention, which again will increase the volume substantially. So there's a lot of useful elements to that. They've got existing customers that we could tap some of our equipment into as well. There's already 160 of those in laboratories, you know, before we got involved. So there's 160 laboratories that we could actually have some of our equipment going in. And don't forget, you know, the equipment in modern water is not just about, you know, detecting contaminations in water. It can detect 2,700 plus different virus, bacteria and toxins in a small unit. So we're looking at ways to develop that and exploit that a little bit further in our channel and also ours in there. So it's very good.
So cross-selling on the cards then?
Very much so. Very much so, yeah.
Let's talk about expansion this year.
Okay, so, I mean, there's a lot happening. I just, you know, alluded to the three towers that we have. Certainly, with the news flow between now and the end of March, it seems to be all coming to a head. So, you know, over the next few weeks, there will be quite a substantial amount of news coming out relating to our COVID projects, relating to our Skin Trust Club, which will be launched in March, and the Lab Skin, adding our two container level three laboratories in York, which means that we can handle dangerous pathogens such as the virus in-house and continue the testing. So we've hired, we continue to hire, we are, you know, actively seeking new members of the science team, new members of our marketing team. Basically, it's all guns blazing from our perspective. The China office obviously will have production in the second quarter. The US expansion, our upgrading of our laboratories over there will be later this year as well. So, yeah, we're comfortable this year. What's that?
Global expansion.
Certainly global expansion. All of the distribution channels we're tapping in further and increasing our revenue per client in the lab skin side of the business. We're increasing the actual monitoring in all of our equipment installation with modern water. And certainly on the B2C Skin Trust Club, we've had, you know, a mini pre-registration, and that is 95% conversion rate of people signing in there. Now, obviously, we all want lovely skin, and we'll all have lovely skin in the next quarter.
I like the sound of that. Who doesn't want lovely skin? Joe Brown.
Exactly.
Thank you so much indeed from Deepverge. Always good to have a thorough catch up with you here on Proactive London.
Looking forward to the next one, Katie.